Hey folks, AJ the CEO here, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to create something like this to spice up your video announcements or any type of thing that you do with your ministry utilizing DaVinci Resolve. So let's go. We're back into doing some more tutorial stuff and focusing on doing some DaVinci Resolve stuff. So I do have the studio version of DaVinci Resolve 20 that is currently out, but this can be done in the free version, all right? So I have links down below to use stuff. You can use whatever. It's the concept that we're going to be using here. So we're just going to open up a new project, and we'll do, I'll just call it mock-up. You can call it whatever you want. I've done this multiple times before, like in announcements and stuff like that, just to make it kind of catch people off guard with it. So I like doing that. So let me turn off dual screen mode so this is easy for me to do here. So first thing we're going to do, let's go ahead and bring our media that I have links for. And you can use any type of media that you want, but this one is what I use because it just makes it easy to understand the concept. All right, so we have our two clips here. If we go double click on the first one here, it is just this person holding this laptop. So I'm not going to use the entire footage. We don't need it. If I go forward a little bit, this person actually starts moving, and then we got to deal with a hand coming in front of that stuff, and I'm not ready to do that. So inside of our footage, I'm just going to play forward, and once we get to the part where we don't want it anymore, which is right before this hand starts moving, I'm going to press the O button, or you can press the out mark right here, either one. So that's the only clip we're going to use. So from here, I'm going to drag this down here, and there's our clip. So just going forward, it's just a person kind of moving just a little bit, but just the laptop, and there's no hands moving, nothing like that. All right, with that clip selected, let's go ahead and click the Fusion button, and now we're in Fusion. Now, we can come over here to Effects. Now, real quick, don't get intimidated by this. I am slow on the Fusion stuff. So again, slowly building up the skills inside of here, but don't get intimidated by this. It's a different mindset of understanding Fusion. But anyway, we have our media in one, which is this one right here. If you're not ever seeing your stuff here and we have it connected to media out, so you're not seeing anything, you could just drag it up here and that's how you can see it. That's where that little dot is. But we're going to drag the media in one into our media out. That's ultimately what people are going to see. So we drag this up so we're looking at the out. With media in one selected, under effects, we're going to go to the search and we're going to type in tracker. And we're going to select planar tracker and drag it down until you see the line turn blue. Boom. So there we go. So the planar tracker is going to be able to track objects. So what we're going to do now is we want to look for give DaVinci Resolve as many points as possible to track. So I would think, oh, let me just track the green, but that's just a solid color. That's not points. We want easily identifiable things. So that's green. That's solid. There's no points. So what I want to do is track the entire laptop. So I'm going to make a box around the entire laptop. Here, and then make sure we close it off and connect it back so it's a complete circle. Now, I'm at the beginning of my clip. If you're not, just make sure you're there, and it looks like I wasn't. So let me adjust this box just a little bit because I want to make sure I get it all. All right, so we got our entire laptop selected. We're at the beginning of our clip. Now, under Inspector over here, we're going to hit Set because that's our starting point. We don't need to change anything right now. Let's go ahead and track forward. And you see all these dots? Those are references for tracking. And boom, there's our tracking. So if we scrub back through here, it's following it really good. It didn't jump all over the place and do nothing crazy. All right? Let's go back to the beginning. And now what we're going to do is come over here to our operation mode, and we're going to change this to corner pin. And now we want to move this box to the exact area that we want to replace, which is going to be the green. So I'm going to come in here and get to the corners here. And if you need to, I'm going to hold down the control, or I believe it's the command on Mac. And now I'm going to use my mouse wheel so I can zoom in, so I can get a little bit closer here. And I am trying to move this right here to each one of the corners of this green, because that's exactly what I want, that data that's tracking the movement, but this is the area that I want to concentrate on. So if I zoom out, or we can come up here and hit fit the screen. Let's close effects. We don't need that. And if we play it, is that box jumping all over the place? Just a little bit at the corner, but we can fix that. All we got to do is go to that exact frame of where it got loose from, and it jumped all over the place here. So let's move this back here. And this is a reason why, honestly, I like doing shorter clips, because if it gets out of whack, we just come in here and make that slight adjustment at each keyframe. And the longer the clip, the more work this would be. We just scoop this over just a little bit. Good. So we're good right here. So now let's go back to our media. And for our clip number two, whatever it is, we're just going to drag it down into the nodes window. And now we have a media two. The output here, this little gray box here, we're going to click on that and drag it to the green arrow, which represents the tracking information of what we just did. So we're going to take the output and let it go to the planar tracker onto that green line. And now our video is where we just did it. So if we followed that appropriately, when we play, let's go back to the beginning. So you can see right here, it went a little bit off the laptop. Let's make a slight adjustment there. So now if we play this, that video is matching. It's just a couple of points in here where we got to make some corrections, because it's just cutting a little bit out. But for the most part, following pretty good. So you might just need to make a few little corrections here and there, but for the most part, we're good. So now, let's come out of this and go to edit, and let's do full screen, and let's look at the full result. So like you see, there is some green, so we do have to do a little bit of cleanup right there, but it gets you close to what you're doing. So if we play it, except for a couple of spots right there, looks really, really good. So that's just one little tool of how you can use Fusion to superimpose like a video on top of it. Now, what's the context of how you would do this? Say you want to have a short announcement, or you want to do a reel or something. You want to catch everybody off guard. So you have a video of somebody holding a tablet or a laptop, and you can superimpose your video from your service onto that. And then you can say, hey, make sure you like and subscribe and follow us here. We're here on every whatever day that you have service. And that could be a 10-second reel, a clip that you can do, put it on social media. And it just catches everybody off guard, because it's like, man, that looks super professional. Because it does, because you got the free tools, DaVinci Resolve, which is free, that you can do that. And you can amp up your ministry in any type of way. So if you like these type of tools and tips and video editing stuff, please let me know down below, and we'll focus on doing some more stuff. As I learn more, I will share that with y'all so that we can all get our skills better and we can do some more stuff. Now, again, you could do stuff like this with AI, but sometimes AI does not produce exactly what you want. And I'm still one of those persons that I use AI, but I still want to know how to do this, because if AI doesn't get it exactly the way I want to, I want to know how to make it myself. And again, they're free tools, and it's a new skill that you learn. So anyway, I think that's about it. So if you like this type of content, appreciate a like, consider subscribing, hit that bell, that way you get notified when we come out with other videos to help modernize your media ministry. Thanks for watching, folks. This is AJ. Catch you on the next video. Later.